folks, as I mentioned last week, I'm introducing you this time to Sanibel. Sanibel is the second kitty we got. We got her when Chessie was about 2 years old so that he'd have somebody to play with while we were gone all day at work. We had just recently come back from a vacation, our first, and our first time visiting this little island that's about 3.5-4 hours south of us here in Florida. It's called Sanibel. It's a beautiful little island. I loved it there. I absolutely loved it there. And we have since gone back several times. It's our favorite place to go. But when we got back, we decided, you know, we're going to get another kitty. And we went to the local SPCA. So Nofer Blatz and I are wandering around, and all the cats are in these different little cages. They're multi-layered, you know, 3 or 4 tiers high, and each cat is in an individual little cage. And they're in different little rooms. Well, he found a cat in one room that he thought was beautiful. He just saw it. I don't know if it was male or female, but he just went by how beautiful this cat was. Well, I ended up in a different room. And at the far end of the room, there was a little kitten, and its paw was reaching out of the cage saying, "Please, please, come see me, please." His little gray paw. So of course I had to go over there and see. And this little kitten was a gray tortoise. That means that their coats are kind of splotchy, and she was grays and beiges, as you're gonna see in the various photos. Well, they let you take the kitties out and hold them, you know, to see how well you mesh with this cat. So this one obviously wanted to come out. So I pulled her out of her little cage, and oh, she just instantly was, "Oh, I love you. Please take me home. Don't put me back." She actually ended up wrapping herself around my neck. If you remember when I was talking about the kitten my mom brought home from work that went to sleep on my mom's neck, well, I got to experience sort of the same thing. She literally would. She was wrapped around my neck, basically, and did not want me to put her down. So Nofer Blatz and I, you know, we get together and we're talking, and he really likes this other cat that's so beautiful, and he thought that this little kitten was ugly. And she had a beautiful bone structure, gorgeous, gorgeous bone structure, but her coat is a tortie coat. It's splotchy. It's, you know, not solid, not tabby, and he didn't really like the look of her. So, but I prevailed. I mean, how can you argue? This little kitten was so sweet, you know. We decided we're going to take this one, and she was still too young to be spayed. She was quite young. We you know, go and check out, so to speak. And it's time to put her, I mean, the whole time now, she has been wrapped on me and won't let me put her down. But it was time we had to put her in the carrier. It was all I could do to peel her off of me to put her in the carrier so that we could take her home. Finally did succeed. And we named her Sanibel. Now, the name Sanibel came from her coat, really. The colors of her coat were very reminiscent of the beaches and the shells we just were enjoying down on Sanibel Island. But as I mentioned in last week's video, it doesn't take Nofer Blatz long to come up with a nickname. So she quickly got a nickname. I can't remember if it started out as Splatters, I think, but it became Splatties. And Splatties is what we end up calling her most of the time. And that kind of fit when you see her coat. So Splatties came home, and as I mentioned last week when I was talking about Chessie, he loved to terrorize her. He just loved to just get in her face and intimidate her. And she just never took to him. I mean, I'm going to show you a photo, one or two photos, I can't remember which, that you know, she's right next to a couple of the other cats. She did sometimes tolerate him, but as time went on, as she got older, she became less tolerant of any of the cats. The only one that she would kind of sort of tolerate was this other female that we ended up with called Tiki. Little Siamese, and I'll tell you about her next week. For the most part, though, she didn't have much use for cats. She liked humans. She just wasn't too crazy about cats. I take it back. She liked the humans in her family, and she was okay with women. She didn't like men. She put up with Neverblatz, but she didn't like men otherwise. Now, she had a few other quirks. She was very lithe cat. And she liked to be up in high places, as many cats do. She loved to get up on top of the refrigerator. And there was one day, we were just trying to find her. And I should say that, as I mentioned two videos ago, my cats stay indoors. They don't go outside. So when they're missing, that doesn't make a lot of sense, because they never go outside. Anyway, we were trying to find her. We're going all through the house, and we can't find her anywhere. We finally did find her. In all places, on the top edge of a door. Yes. The closet door, for some reason, was slightly ajar. And she was there, balanced, on the very top edge of this door. Thankfully, one of us happened to look up and we saw her. How she got up there, we don't know. She either jumped from the floor all the way up there, or she jumped from the dining room table, because this was the closet by the front door, and perhaps that way. We don't know. But somehow she got up on this door. She also once got trapped in the linen closet. We had gone on vacation, and a friend was coming over to feed the cats while we were gone and clean their litter box. And the day before we were due to come back, for some reason, this friend had opened the linen closet and splatties got in there. And the friend didn't realize it and closed the linen closet. And Splatty spent the night in the linen closet, because we got home the next day. And we're looking for her. We can't find her. And we hear the sound and open the door and, oh, there she is. Thankfully, she didn't destroy the linens being in there overnight. The other quirks about splatties, oh, God. She was very athletic. She liked to do what we call skateboarding. Have you ever seen skateboarders? And they'll skateboard up almost sideways on something, right? Well, she would do that. She would go running and hit the couch, the back side of our couch in the living room, and so she would be horizontal, I guess I should say, running along the back of the couch and then back down on the floor. It was an amazing thing. I wish we'd had a video camera in those days and could have captured that, because it was an amazing thing and quite a loud thing if you were sitting on the couch. The other thing she used to do, she would get into a runner stance before she would go take off running someplace. And now, if you know what I mean by runner stance, they get down and they've got the little block that they have their foot on, you know what I'm saying? She would do that. But her block was the wall. So she would back her rear end so that her back feet were on the wall behind her and her front feet on the floor. And she would get in this little crouch and then take off. She would spring off the wall and go vroom through the house. Quirky little cat. She was the tiniest cat, the smallest cat we had. And yet, as tiny and delicate as she was, she made the most noise when she jumped on something. She would jump on the back of the couch and you would have thought a pile of bricks just dropped. And yet Pookie, much bigger than her, could jump on the back of the couch and you'd never know it. He was silent. She made a lot of noise. She was also a little klutzy. She would sometimes not quite land her landings. We used to say she was too ornery to die. She was. She was quite ornery. She lived a very, very long time. I'm thinking she may have been close to 18 when she died. So in my book, she was a sweetheart. She just wasn't a sweetheart to the other cats and sometimes other humans. Anyway, here's some photos of her. She liked to spend a lot of time on Neverblatz's lap when she was little, as you can see here. And then there she is again on Neverblatz's lap. I love that pose, though. And then here she is again on Neverblatz's lap. She's cute. And now our daughter also got the treatment, as you can see. But her favorite place to be? A box. If there was a box on the floor, she was in it. And now here's that picture I was telling you about with her and Pookie. Aren't they cute? There's my pretty girl. I don't care what Neverblatz says. I think she was pretty. This was one of her favorite games, playing in Overblast's chair. She would dance around the arm of the chair. There she is on the back of the couch looking down at you. What a face. There's my pretty girl. And this pose, not very ladylike, I'm afraid. Then we have this classic Sanibel, if I ever saw it. Well, now you've met Splatties, the grand dame of the family. Let's see, next week it'll be Tiki, the first Siamese. See you then.
See ya.